Welcome back to the Hunter Call of the Wild. So we finally got the reveal of the new map that is coming to the Hunter Call of the Wild, and that is Silver Ridge Peaks, which is a rocky mountain map. And man, that landscape that they showed in the stream on Tuesday looked fantastic. We had high peaks of mountains, we had valleys with dense forests, and then we had plains with a bit more grassy areas for different species. And with the new map, we're gonna get a new weapon. And this weapon wasn't told what it is, but it's a weapon, not specifically a gun. So that's gonna be interesting to see what it's gonna be. And the map will have 9 species. And from this 9, we have 5 new ones and 4 recycled. So we have a broghorn, which for me, I have never seen this deer before, and it looked really, really interesting. And we happened to have a diamond one shot on the stream. TK got really lucky with that one. Then we have mountain goat, which are living on the higher mountains, white goats. And these guys looked also really interesting. Most of these species on the map, I have never seen before. So they're all basically brand new for me. And the next one we got Rocky Mountain Elk, and this is different model and had different true racks from the Roosevelt Elk here from here in Layton Lakes, and they get a lot bigger than the Roosevelts. Their diamond was something 481 points for the minimum score, so they get a lot bigger than the Roosevelts. And the model itself looked really good, and I actually liked the true racks a lot more than the Roosevelts. And then we have mule deer, which is the same mule deer that we have in the Parque Fernando. And they will have true racks, but not on launch. So they are gonna work on the true racks and take their time with it, just like they did with the red deer. And they don't want to mess it up. So we're gonna give them the time. We want good true racks. So that's coming sometime after the launch. And then we have mountain lion, which is exactly the same as the puma, as it's the same species, just known with different name in different parts of the world. Plains bison from the Yukon, which is the same species. It's gonna probably go around on these plains that are on the map. And black bear. And black bear, same as in the Layton Lakes, so it's nice to have the black bear in a different map too. And then the most wanted and expected species probably in the whole Call of the Wild's history, the turkeys. And the turkeys, the animals, the models, the animations looked really good. I really liked how they actually behaved and looked like a turkey, but they had some texture issues, like people pointing out that the hens have red hair, red head and stuff like that, and that some of the textures were not right. So they're gonna do some fixes on those before the launch. But the models itself, they looked really nice. And then we get 2 new collars for the turkey. We have a mouth collar, which is for attracting the turkeys to you. And that one has a really long range. It was 500 meters. So that range is actually the same as for the duck collar. It just also has really long range. But this one, because the turkeys are mainly ground-based, you're gonna have turkeys coming from pretty far away to your calls. And then we got crow caller, which is for getting a vocal response from the turkeys. So basically, they give you response so you can locate where the turkeys are and how far or close they are at the moment. And then we get decoys for the hens and the toms. And those are the basics that we have for the map. I can't wait to go hunt there. At the end of the stream, TK was hunting on a really dense forest in some of the valleys, and that looked fantastic. As a bow hunter in the game, I can't wait to have really thick forest with a lot of underbrush where I can slowly creep in and close to the animals. But then there was few things that might upset people. Before the reveal, I was talking to people about what they have expectations for the turkeys, and a lot of people wanted to have a really difficult hunt. have the turkeys roam the map, so they have to actually set up a blind and set up and call the animals in, instead of finding need zones and just camping those. And in this regard, the turkeys actually have need zones, and they have also a drink zone. And that is, in my personal opinion, is probably gonna take away quite a bit the fun from the turkeys for people, because the map is not having a lot of water. From the map that I saw, they have little amount of small lakes, and these small lakes can be used for the turkey hunting pretty effectively. And also my other concern is that because the map doesn't have that much water, the drink zones are gonna be even more OP than before. We had this issue a bit in the Cuatro Colinas, where they introduced the ibex, and the ibex were told that they have four hills and you have to hunt them in the hills with open areas, so they're gonna be difficult to hunt. But then they only had like one or two lakes around the hills, and the ibex went to those lakes to drink, and you could just camp the lakes and never actually hunt the ibex on the hills. So I feel like the similar thing is gonna happen with the turkeys. People are just gonna find the drink zones, go there and shoot from 150 meters with the 22 LR and never actually utilize the turkey decoys or the blind or setup or the caller. And I think that's gonna make the experience a bit less fun for a lot of people. And at least I've seen that kind of response from the players. A lot of people are worried that the turkeys are not gonna be too much fun to hunt when you can pinpoint the location. I've been again talk with people, and the best way people feel like this situation could be fixed is to remove the drink zone from the turkey. You can keep the feed zone and the rest zone, because those zones are usually in a bit thicker brush and you have to actually explore the map to find them. Drink zones are easy to locate because you can open the map and see, there is water, they're gonna drink there. Same thing is not happening with the feed and drink zone, with the feed and the rest zones. You have to actually find and scout for those spots. And then you can, this would make people to actually make the setups to utilize the decoys, the blinds and the long range callers, to make a setup around next to an open field, put decoys on the field and call the turkeys in. I've seen a lot of videos of the bird turkey hunting in real life. I've done some research on that, and that's how they actually are hunted most of the time. You scout the animals, then you go to their location, you set up your decoys and blind, and then you call and wait for the turkeys to come in. And because the turkeys have excellent hearing and eyesight, you don't want to be in open field where they can actually see and hear you coming from far away. Don't take this feedback that I'm actually hating the map and I'm not gonna play it ever. No, this is the complete opposite. I care about the game and I want the game to be really good. And from the initial stuff that they have shown, I want to express my feedback and my concerns about these decisions. I have done similar things with the scoring 2.0 when it went to beta, and they listened to the community, and I really hope the EW reads these feedbacks, listens to the players and decides to do something a bit different, at least for the drink zones, for the turkeys. So what do you guys think about the Rocky Mountain map? Do you want to have the need zones for the turkeys? What is your opinion on that? Leave comments down below, then let us know and let EW know what we think about this situation. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and as always, have fun, happy hunting, and I see you on the next one. Bye bye. We'll be right back.